cold and flu are spread by droplets, you know. So, you know, and these are very tiny, aerosols, you know, which and they can be spread either from, you know, in the air or on contaminated surfaces. So if you do develop any of the symptoms that we described, there's certain things that you should be doing, and also if somebody in the household has these symptoms, they should be doing as well. And I'm just going to quickly go through these because a lot of people already know this from the precautions that we've taken from COVID. For example, you know, wash your hands regularly with soap and water. You know, avoid touching your eyes and your nose and your mouth with your unwashed hands. If you are sick, stay at home. Don't venture to go to school, you know, if you or to work and infect your colleagues or your fellow student. If your child goes to a daycare, keep them home, because in a daycare is a setting where it can, you know, viruses can like this can spread like wildfire. You know, avoid hugging, kissing, shaking hands. I know if you have symptoms, you know, it's very difficult. Like in this kind of environment, you know, people come out, they shake hands. You know, it's difficult to, you feel like you're obliged to shake. But if you have symptoms, just say, it's best to say, brother, you know, I'm sick, you know, I don't want to shake your hands. I mean, if you say it like that, they won't be offended, you know, because people take it personally if you take your hands and don't explain why you're not shaking your hands. So it's okay to just say, brother, I'm sick, so I don't want to get you ill, you know. So if you have these symptoms, don't shake your hands, because, you know, that's how one of the ways that the virus is spread. And if you are coughing and sneezing, don't cough into your hands, because you're automatically infecting your hands or you're contaminating your hands. You know, if you have a tissue, use a tissue. If you don't have a tissue, just use your sleeve. You know, just, you know, cough into your arm. The other thing is, as I mentioned, surfaces are often contaminated. If wipe them down regularly with antiseptic, whether it be computer boards, toys, anything that you're using frequently. And one thing is, I would probably encourage, even for even if you're in the house, to avoid infecting your own family members. Just wear a mask, because the mask can actually stop the virus, both, you know, cold, flu, COVID. It can stop, you know, the others around you from getting infected. So even without the COVID, if you have the flu or the cold, wearing a mask in the house can protect your own family members. So I usually recommend that, even in your own household, if you're sick. The thing is, in this pandemic, obviously a lot of these symptoms overlap, right? So you don't often know whether you got the flu, whether you got the cold, or you got COVID. So testing is obviously, as I mentioned, is very important. So it's very important that if you're in a pandemic like this, get tested for the COVID and the flu. I mean, there's no test for the cold, right? So at least the COVID and flu, there are tests available. In a pandemic, when you don't know, when you're not sure what you have, just go and get tested. And if your COVID test comes back positive, what do you do? If you're feeling okay, you know, you're not short of breath, anything like that, you stay at home, isolate in your home for at least 10 days. That's the CDC recommendation, and you stay in home. Other family members that you have should also be tested, you know, get them tested as well, and they should be in quarantine as well, because obviously if you've been in the household with them for hours and day, you know, they could very well be infected as well, and they could be in the incubation period. As far as the siblings of kids that are infected, you know, they should all stay at home, unless the other siblings have been fully vaccinated, don't have any symptoms at all. They can still go to school as long as they wear a mask, okay? Because we've had this situation in PVS recently. If you do have COVID, one of the things that the most important, you know, thing to that I recommend people when they call me, what should I do? If you can go and get a pulse oximeter, an oxygen meter from Walgreens or any pharmacy, I would strongly recommend, if you have COVID and you're isolating, That's the most objective way to monitor yourself. Get an oxygen pulse oximeter, because then you can tell whether your oxygen level is going up or, you know, it's sinking down. You can't tell clinically if your oxygen level has dropped from 96% to 93%. You can't tell that. But if you have an oxygen meter, you have an objective evidence. And then I usually, if the oxygen saturation drops to below 92%, that's when I tell them you better go to the hospital, because things could go downhill pretty quickly. So you know, if you're above 92%, you know, you just gotta watch, be careful. But if you drop to probably below 92%, that's probably the time you should start thinking about going to the hospital.